next one. Hello to everybody, and warmly welcome all of you people to listen the online classes of our esteemed institution, Diamond Group of Institution. I am P. Chandrasekhar, Zoology faculty, and today we'll deal the different to previous questions which are NEET and AIIMS level, and the topic is this is the topic exceeded products and their elimination. Okay. And the questions as follows. So the first question is, a terrestrial animal must be able to, the terrestrial animal must be able to, A, conserve water, B, the B option is excrete large amount of salts in urine, and C option is excrete large amount of salts in water and actually pump salts out through the skin itself. Before, I would like to explain that actually the terrestrial animals are the only living organisms which are truly facing the scarcity of the water, in particularly which are living in the deserts itself. So that's why they have to develop the adaptive character to conserve the water itself. So that's why the question is asking that here the terrestrial animal must be able to conserve the water itself. So that's why the A option is correct option for this question, that is called conserve water. And B, the excrete large amount of salts in urine, it is not at all concerned. And excrete large amount of salts in water is also not concerned this. And D option is actually pump salts out of through skin is also not concerned with this. So that's why among the A, B, C, D, the A option is related to this question. So I am opting the A option as the correct option for this question. And after that we go for the next question. The second question is like this. When a freshwater protozoan, when a freshwater protozoan possessing a contractile vacuole is placed in a glass containing marine water, the vacuole will. First of all, we have to learn what is the nature. Of course, here in protozoan organism, whatever the protoplasm is so far present in the amoeba, which has more concentrated protoplasm when you compare with the concentrated or less concentrated surrounding water. So what is the nature of the water? The water is always flows from lower concentrated medium into the higher concentrated medium. Here in case of protozoan, the surrounding water is continuously flows into the protoplasm of the amoeba itself. In order to maintain the osmoregulation, it need of contractile vacuole. So with help of contractile vacuole, which is always send the excessive water from the protoplasm and from the body into the surrounding itself. Osmoregulated organ which is present in the form of contractile vacuole to compensate the or to maintain the excess of water to live a perfect life in the freshwater environment itself. If the protozoan amoeba may be placed in the marine water, certainly what happens regarding the contractile vacuole? One is the A option is the increase in size. There is no increase at all, and decrease in size, and of course increase in number. Of course the size of the vacuole is not affected here. See the increasing in number. So here the A option and B option, C option is also not related to this question. Suddenly what happens? The marine water concentration is increased or more than the concentration of the protoplasm itself. For sake of that, and whatever the contractile vacuole is so far present in the freshwater protozoan like amoeba, the contractile vacuole is simply disappeared from the body itself. So that's why in just the four of the options like A, B, C, D, the D option is related to this question itself. So I'm opting the D option for this question. Now after that, we go for the other question. We go for the other question now. If liver from body is removed, If liver from body is removed, then which component of blood increases? So that you know that after liver, very important internal organ of human being is itself is called liver. The liver is performing more than 18 to 20 different functions of the body of human being itself. If the liver is removed from the body, what happens to the, what change can be affected within the body of human being itself? The options are like this. Urea, the increasing the urea can be increased in liver. No, the B, the proteins are increased in liver. No, the uric acid is not increased in liver because of ammonia. Because of whatever the proteins are so far, whatever the food particles are so far taken by the human being, that is initially converted into the ammonia itself. If the ammonia is systematically converted into urea by the ornithine cycle of the human being, which is held in the liver itself. If the liver is not present in the body, certainly the digested food particles, particularly the proteins, are supposed to enter, just converted into the amino acid. And the removal of the amino group of the amino acids are simply converted into ammonia itself. If the liver is not present in our body, certainly the ammonia, the level of the ammonia can be increased in the liver of human being itself. So that's why the ammonia is included under D. So the D option is related to this question itself. Either of urea, protein and uric acid. No, and D, the ammonia is related to this question. That's why opting the D option for this question itself. And after that, you go for the next question. Here, in which of the following region of nephron does maximum reabsorption of useful material occurs? Already you know that a pair of kidneys are present to perform the excretion of the waste products of the human body itself. So naturally here, the Bowman capsule, of course the functional unit of the kidney can be named as the nephron. The nephron is simply differentiated into two of the parts itself, Bowman capsule and renal capsules also. Here, the renal tubule is simply consists of the following parts itself, PCT and loop of Henle and DCT and collecting duct itself. Okay, and after that, here the PCT, here loop of Henle is always helpful in the conservation of the water to form the, to prepare the hypertonic urine itself. Glomerulus is helpful to filter the useful food particles and useful amino acids and useful nutrients which are carried into the glomerulus with help of efferent renal arteriole itself. And DCT, of course DCT is also helpful to absorb the remaining 15% of the water and elements and useful nutrients from the urine itself. Now the D option is the correct option, PCT. The plasmal convoluted tubule is the only part of the nephron which is participating in the reabsorption of maximum amount of the water and nutrients and useful solutes also. 70 to 80% of the water nutrients can be absorbed within the PCT part. What is the PCT? Plasmal convoluted tubule is playing vital role to reabsorb the maximum reabsorption of useful material occurs itself. So in between A, B, C, D, D is the correct option for this question. So I am going to be opt the B option here as the correct answer for this question. And after that we go for the other question. Now the other question is, which one of the following groups of structures organs have similar function itself? Once again, which one of the following groups of the structures organs have similar function? The options are like this. Typrosol in earthworm. You know that typrosol is one of the specialized part which is present in the intestine itself, which is extended from 23 to 26 segments of the alimentary canal of the earthworm, which is helpful to enhance the absorbing surface area. In case of intestine in rat also, so intestine in rat is also helpful in the reabsorption or absorption of the digested food particles, and here and contractile vacuole in amoeba itself. What I say now, contractile vacuole is always helps in the maintaining the excess of water which is carried into the body of amoeba itself. So that's why triplosole is different, functionally different from intestinal rat, and as well as these two of the parts of the ectomorphic rat are not functionally similar to the contractile vacuole in amoeba itself. That's why A option is not at all suited to this question, and B option, nephridian ectoderm. Of course you know that the nephridia performing the excretion of the ectoderm, and malpighian tubules in the cockroach. Malpighian tubules are the chief excretory organs of the cockroach, and as well as urinary tubule in rats. Urinary tubule is the excretory structure of the rat like mammal itself. Here in B option, nephridia of ectoderm and malpighian tubules in cockroach and urinary tubule in rat is functionally similar itself. And after that, the B option is correct for this question. And after that, you go for the C option, antenna of cockroach. Antenna of cockroach is helpful in the sensory activity itself. Tympanum of frog is hearing the sound vibration from the environments. And the trichelium of the earthworm is helpful to form the cocoon formation in the earthworm after fertilization or after copulation itself. And it means that the antenna of cockroach, tympanum of frog, and trichelium of earthworm are not functionally similar. So that's why C option is also not related to this question. And D option, incisors of rat. Incisors, one among the four types of the teeth can be present in the mammal. The incisors are helpful in the cutting of the food particles itself. Whereas the gizzard of the cockroach, which is helpful in the grinding of the food particles, and 2 feet of starfish, which are helpful in the locomotion itself. That's why incisors of rat, gizzard of cockroach and 2 feet of starfish are not functionally similar. So among the ABCD, A, C, D are not related with this question. Only B option is correct option for this question. So I am concluding to select a B option itself. Now and after that you go for the other question. The sixth question, Diabetes insipidus. Diabetes insipidus is caused by the deficiency of the hormone. You already know that. What do you mean of diabetes? That means the constant level of the glucose in the blood of a man is not maintained by the body itself. The pancreas is name of the gland which can be secreted 2 kinds of the hormones itself. One is the insulin and second one is the glucagon. Insulin and glucagon, these two of the hormones are functionally antagonistic to each other itself. Insulin is simply called as hyperglycemic hormone, whereas glucagon is always named as the hypoglycemic hormone itself. These two of the hormones are perfectly maintaining the glucose level in the blood of a man. In which of the human being, these two of the hormones are secreted sufficiently to maintain the constant level of the glucose in the blood, they are looking like a normal people. So in case of the insulin is not secreted sufficiently, certainly there is no proper conversion of the glucose into the glycogen. So that will be leads into enhancement or increasing level of the glucose in the blood is leads into effect of diabetes itself. The diabetes are 2 types, diabetes mellitus and second one is the diabetes insipidus itself. Diabetes mellitus is affected among the people due to the insufficient amount of the insulin can be secreted by the pancreatic gland. Whereas the second type of the diabetes can be named as the diabetes insipidus, which is caused by the deficiency of the ADH hormone, vasopressin / ADH hormone, anti-diuretic hormone is not sufficiently secreted. So naturally, if the ADH hormone is deficiently secreted in the body, that should be leads into diabetes insipidus itself. Now the options are given like this. A, insulin. Insulin is causing the diabetes mellitus, not causing the diabetes insipidus itself. That's why A option is not related to this. B option is the vasopressin. The vasopressin oblique is also called as the ADH hormone. So the vasopressin oblique ADH hormone became deficiency, that will be leads into cause of the diabetes insipidus. That's why B option is correct. And in case of C, glucagon is secreted by alpha cells of the exocrine, just the endocrine part of the pancreas, which is always converting the glycogen into the glucose. It is not at all concerned with the causing of diabetes insipidus. And after that, the oxytocin. Oxytocin is the another hormone which causes the, or else which can be stimulate the mammary glands to eject the milk whenever the children's newborn children's can be suck the milk from the mammary glands itself. So that's why between A, B, C, D, only B option is correct for this question, and A, C, D are not related with this question. That's why opting the B option for this question. And after that you go for the other question. The question is like this. Podocytes. The podocytes are a kind of specialized cells where they can be present. Podocytes are the cells present in. Now the options are like this. A option, cortex of nephron. Of course you know that. The functional unit of the kidneys itself is called nephron. So anatomically the kidneys simply classified into two of the regions. Peripheral part is the cortex and the central part or central located part is called medulla itself. Here the podocytes are not concerned, not connect, just not lying the cortex of the nephron. And B is the inner wall of Bowman capsule. B option is the correct option. Inner wall of the Bowman capsule is naturally lined with the podocyte for sake of filtering the different nutrients which are carried into the Bowman capsule with the help of efferent renal artery itself. And after that C, outer wall of the Bowman capsule. It is not at all concerned. And D is the wall of glomerulus capillaries itself. Here D option is also not concerned with the podocytes itself. Only the B option is the correct option for this. The inner wall of the Bowman capsule is lined by the podocytes. And apart from the B, A, C, D are not related with this question. So I am opting the B option as the correct option for this question itself. Now you to opt the B option for the correct option for this. Now after that, you go for the other question. Now the 8th question is like that. A person who is on a long hanger strike and surviving only on water will have. So naturally, a person who is on a long hanger strike and surviving only on water will have. He used to take the water and when he was in hanger strike, he is unable to take any other food part. He only used to take the water. If for a longer time, when he relies on the intake of water, not taking of any food particle, what will changes will be take place within the body itself. The options are like this. A option is the less urea in his urine itself. It is not at all concerned. More sodium ions in the urine itself. Naturally, the more sodium ions can be present in urine itself. Whatever the water is so far taken, that will be accumulated more sodium ions in his urine itself. So that's why B option is correct option for this. And C is the less amino acids in his urine. Because of he doesn't take in any kind of the proteins into the body because of he sit in the hanger strike for a longer period. He is not able to take any kind of the food particles itself. That's why there is no intake of proteins. There is no presence of the amino acids in his urine itself. And after the D option is the more glucose in his blood also. Not only that, if he is also not taking any kind of the carbohydrates in the diet, only is exclusively leaving his life on the water itself. That's why more glucose in his blood is also not related with this question. So among the four of the options, like A, B, C, D, only B option is correct option. More sodium ions are present in his urine itself. and after that you go for the other question. The ninth question, in ornithine cycle, which of the following wastes are removed from the blood itself? The ornithine cycle or Kori-Kori cycle, and different cycles are going to be take place within the liver itself. The what I am saying that liver is very important part, other than of course here our heart and lungs and other things also. Here if the ornithine cycle is very important cycle to remove the some of the toxic substances from the blood itself. Okay, now the options are like this: urea and urine. Of course the urea, the conversion of ammonia into urea in one of the cycle will be take place within the liver, but the urea and urine is not removed from the blood itself. B, the ammonia and urea, and B option is also not correct to that, and C option is the correct option, CO2 and ammonia. Carbon dioxide, ammonia are simultaneously removed from the blood when the ornithine cycle is supposed to take place in the liver itself. What is the ornithine cycle? The removal of undergrowth from the amino acids which are synthesized within the body by digesting the proteins into amino acids itself. That's why the ornithine cycle is always look after to elimination of carbon dioxide and ammonia from the blood. And that's why C option is correct option for this question, whereas D, the CO2 and urea itself. Only among ABCD, the C option is related with this question. So that's why I'm opting the C option as the correct option for this question. Now we go to select the C option for this question. Now we go for the other question. Now 10th question is during strenuous exercise glucose is converted into. The people are vigorously doing the physical exercise and certainly the glucose is suddenly converted into. A option is like this: glycogen, pyruvic acid and starch, and D is the lactic acid. Glycogen in normal condition, the glucose is naturally converted into glycogen by the action of insulin. And where is pyruvic acid? Pyruvic acid in the absence of the oxygen or the vigorous contraction of the muscles under anaerobic condition, the glucose can be converted into pyruvic acid. And C option is the starch. Of course, starch is nothing but the raw material which is taken by the human beings into the alimentary canal, that will be called as a starch or carbohydrate. Here, the strenuous exercise is converted the most of the glucose into the lactic acid. So, if the more amount of the lactic acid is deposited in the muscles of the body, the muscles are going to be undergoes fatigue itself. That's why in this question, D option is correct option for this question. D is the lactic acid. During the strenuous exercise, glucose is converted into the lactic acid, not starch into, or not converted into pyruvic acid, and not converted into glycogen. So among the ABCD, the D option is correct for this question. So I'm opting the D option for this. After 10th question, now you go for the 11th question. Region of nephron found in renal medulla is. That means two of the important parts are present in the nephron. One is called the loop of Henle, and as well as second part is the vasa recta. So on the basis of these two of the parts, the nephrons are simply classified into two types: cortical nephrons and the juxta-glomerular nephrons are also present. So the most of the, more than 80% of the living mammals will be contained the cortical nephrons instead of juxta-glomerular nephrons itself. Okay. And now regarding this, the region of nephron found in renal medulla is. And of course, A option is like this: malfusion corpuscles are not at all present in the renal medulla itself. And PCT and DCT. PCT and DCT are not at all present in the medullary part. These two of the parts are mostly concerned with the cortex part of the nephron itself. The loop of ND is the only part which is confined to the medullary part of the nephron. In addition to that, what I said, vasa recta is one of the blood capillary, network of the blood capillary. These two of the specialized structures are confined to the medullary part of the nephron itself. So on the basis of that, Malpighian corpuscles PCT and DCT are not supposed to present in the medullary part of the nephron. Only in ABCD options, only one of the options is correctly given, that is called the loop of Henle, the only one part of the nephron which is confined to the medullary part of the nephron itself. That's why I am opting the D option as the correct option for this question. Now you go for the other question. The question is like this. Identify the correctly matched pair. So the question is asking that identify the correctly matched pair, and of course the options are given like that. 1, 2, 3. One is the uremia, excess of amount of urea in the blood. So if the excess of amount of urea is blood, urea in the blood, that condition of the body can be named as the uremia. And the hyperglycemia, of course hyperglycemia, excess of glucose in blood itself. And hemophilia, options of factor 8 factor. Of course you know that hemophilia, one of the X recessive defective character or disorder itself. And after that glycosuria, what do you mean of glycosuria? Here if the people who are suffering from the diabetes mellitus, if the excess of glucose may be raised in the blood, little amount of the glucose can be carried along with the urine, that condition is itself is called glycosuria. Glycosuria, suria is one of the metabolic disorder. It is not at all linked with the chromosomes itself. That's why the fourth option is not correct option. In case of 1 to 3, uremia is the correct, excess of amount of urea present in the blood. And hypoglycemia is also defined like excess of glucose in the blood. And third option is the hemophilia, options of factor 3 itself. Among 1, 2, 3 are correct, but 4th one is not correct. Now the options are like this. A option, 1, 2 and 3 are correct. Of course, A option is absolutely correct for this question. Whereas B is the 1 and 2 are correct, but not completely taken, another correct answer. And C, the 2 and 4 are correct. What I said, the 4 is not correct, that's why C option is also not correct for this. And D is the 1 and 2, they are equal to into the second year is also correct. So that's why among the A, B, C, D, only A option is correct option for this. So I am also opting the A option as the correct option for this question. Now we go for the other question. The question is like this. Now the question is inflammation of joint. Inflammation means a kind of itching and a kind of pain can be affected within the joint due to the accumulation of uric acid crystals is called. What is the name of the disorder if the people are severely suffering from the joint pains itself? The A option is like this. Gout. And B, the myasthenia gravis. Myasthenia gravis is nothing but it is the muscular fatigue itself. If the defective characters are so far developed in the muscles, the fatigue will be affected, the weakening of the muscles, sometimes it leads into paralysis of the or the non-functional activity of the muscles, that will be called as the myasthenia gravis itself. And osteoporosis. Osteoporosis means the bones, the loss of and the low levels of the calcium may be present in the bones, that will be leads into brittle and fragile. As the fragile nature of the bones can be named as the osteoporosis itself. And osteomalacia itself. That means osteomalacia is breakdown the connection between neurons and as well as muscles itself. That is called osteomalacia. And after that, among A, B, C, D, the A option is the correct option for that. Gout. Gout is nothing but inflammations are naturally takes the different joints of the human body by the deposition of or by accumulation of the more amount of the uric acid crystals in the different joints of the body, that will be, that condition can be named by the gout itself. That's why A option is correct for this question. I have to opt at the A option. Now after that you go for the other question. Now the other question is like that. Uric acid is the chief nitrogenous component of accidental products of. Of course you know that. On the basis of elimination of their accidental products, all the living organisms are so far differentiated and divided into three of the categories. If the chief or the chief eliminatory product of some of the organisms may be present in the form of urea, they are simply called as the ureotelic organism. If the more than 50% of the excretory material can be eliminated by some other organism in the form of ammonia, they are simply called as the ammonotelic. So and after that, some of the living organisms are mostly eliminate their nitrogenous waste material in the form of uric acid, they are simply called as the uricotelic organism itself. My why they are opting a different adaptations to eliminate their excretory product in the form of urea, ammonia and uric acid, because of in order to conserve the water or in order to lead in a perfect life in different environmental conditions of the nature, the all the living organisms are so far developed the different adaptive characters itself. So one among the adaptive character, by expelling the excretory product in different forms itself, some of the aquatic organisms are naturally eliminate the ammonia, and mammals and the amphibians are mostly eliminated their excretory product in the form of urea, and some other organisms like aves, reptiles and insects of the arthropods, and they are the lizards like desert lizards. So these are the some of the group of organisms, they can be eliminated the uric acid as excretory product itself. In this case, now you go for the one of the question. Uric acid is the chief nitrogenous component of the excretory product of. Of course, A, man. Man is belongs to the ureotelic organism. The most of the mammals along the human beings are eliminating the urea as the chief excretory product. That's why A option is not correct. B option is the earthworm. Earthworm is also comes under ureotelic itself. That's why B option is also not correct. Cockroach is one among the insect of the arthropoda. Certainly the cockroach is included under C option. The C option is correct option for this question, because of the cockroach is chiefly excretes its nitrogenous waste material in the form of uric acid. That's why the C option is correct. Whereas frog is belongs to the amphibia, it is also used to eliminate the urea as the excretory product itself. So among the A, B, C, D, the C option is correct for this question. I to opting the C option. Now you go for the other question. The conversion of the dangerous nitrogenous waste into the less toxic excretory matter is carried out to man in the, what I said, the heaviest toxic substances while they are prepared in the body of human being, it is naturally converted into less toxic substances. What is the name of the organ which is then responsible for the conversion of high toxic substances into the less toxic substances? You know that. You know that. Now the options are given like this. The blood. The blood is only described by the connective tissue along with the lymphatic tissue also. The blood is always look after the supply of different hormones, vitamins and digested food particles to each and every part of the body. And the liver is the B option. Liver is the best internal organ. It can be perform the more than 18 to 20 functions of the body. One among the functions of the liver to convert the high toxic substances to the less toxic substances itself. That's why the liver is the correct option for this. The liver is included under B option. And after that, C, the kidney, which is also performing the excellent function, because of whatever the toxic substances are so far converted in the liver, the less toxic excretory material is mostly eliminated by the human body through the kidneys itself. But here the answer is the B option. And D is the skin. Of course, the skin is helpful to protect the internal parts and giving certain shape to the body itself. And skin is also acts like a physical barrier and not permit the infections of the microorganism itself. Just among the ABCD, the B is related answer for this question. I opting the B option as the correct option for this. And after that you go for the other question. And that is the pragmal convoluted tubules is lined with. So what I said now, the nephron is simply consists of the following parts itself. Bowman capsule. The posterior part of the Bowman capsule is simply extended in the form of PCT, that is the nephron. Of course, that is the renal tubule. The renal tubule is simply composed by PCT, DCT, and collecting duct. The collective duct is finally opened into the urinary bladder to store the urine temporarily. Of course, PCT, in between PCT and DCT, a unique characterized and unique part will be present that will be called as the loop of Henle. Particularly the loop of Henle is confined to the mammals. The presence of the loop of Henle is helpful in the conservation of the water itself. By conserving the water, the loop of Henle is always helpful to prepare the hypertonic urine among the mammals itself. Here, the most of the maximum 70 to 80% of the useful material along with the 70 to 80% of the water and useful solutes of the filtrate can be absorbed in the PCT, pragmal convoluted tubule itself. That's why now just here the inner walls of the PCT is simply lined with the a kind of unique or epithelial tissue itself. Now we have to trace out the name of the epithelial layer can be present in inner walls of the PCT itself. One is the cuboidal epithelium. Of course, it is not present in the PCT. And B, the simple brush border epithelium. Little correction is there. That is the columnar epithelium is not at all concerned. And D, the simple cuboidal border epithelium is the only epithelial tissue or epithelial layer which is confined to the inner walls of the PCT itself. But what is the use of border epithelium? Brush border cuboidal epithelium is confined to the inner walls of the PCT because of it can be increase the reabsorbing surface area in the inner walls of the PCT to perfectly reabsorb the water, nutrients and the useful solutes from the filtrate itself. That's why what is the option is correct? D option is the correct option for this. That will be called as the simple cuboidal border epithelium is the only epithelium which lining the inner walls of the PCT to reabsorb the useful substances or nutritive substances and useful solutes. And more of the water is also reabsorbed in this PCT itself due to the presence of the simple cuboidal border epithelium itself. Now we go for the 17th question, that is called bitter canal is present in. Of course, it's the one of the specific structure which is confined to the kidneys of the frog itself. So it is properly named as the bitter canal is present. If particularly the bitter canal is confined to the male frog, not present in the female itself. Because of two of the oval shaped testes can be present in the frog. The testes are functionally connected to the kidneys itself. And here, 11 number of the vasa efferentia are simply connected to the bitter canal of the kidneys of the frog. What is the purpose of bitter canal? Because of there is no specific gonadal or testicular ducts are not so present in the male reproductive system of the frog itself, male frog. So in order to compensate the absence of the testicular ducts, whatever the sperms are so far produced in the testes of the male frog, which are simply carried by vasa efferentia, they immediately shed them into the bitter canal for sake of coming out into the environmental water or surrounding water, for sake of fertilizing the ovum itself. For sake of that, the bitter canal is present in the kidneys of frog. Here, testes is a primary male sex organs, and whereas the kidney of frog is connected here, kidney of rabbit. The bitter canal is not present in the kidney of rabbits. So that's why the C option is also not correct. And D option is given like both A and C. It is also not related to this A and C also. Only the B option is correct option for this kidney of frog. Is associated with the bitter canal itself. Now I am concluding next, just this question and go for the other question. A nephron does not have loop of Henle's. The nephron does not have loop of Henle in which of the organism? Now options are like this. What I said, loop of Henle is a specific or unique part which is confined to the kidneys of mammals only. What is the purpose of presence of the loop of Henle? What I said, the loop of Henle is helpful in the reabsorption of the water or conservation of the water among the mammals. Because of whom? The mammals are the only terrestrial organism, particularly they are leading the terrestrial mode of life. They truly facing the scarcity of the water. In order to compensate the scarcity of the water, they badly need of loop of Henle. For sake of that, they develop the long and longest loop of Henle in their kidneys to conserve the water while they eliminate the waste material in the form of urea or uric acid itself. So the options are given like this. A, frog. B, the man. Of course, man naturally contains the loop of Henle. Rabbit is also one among the mammals, and loop of Henle is naturally present in the rabbit. And dog is also one among the mammals itself. That's why among the A, B, C, D, the A option is correct option, the frog. The frog is naturally belongs to the amphibian. There is no need of presence of the loop of Henle in the amphibian. The best example is given in the form of frog in the A option. That's why A option is correct for this question. So I'm opting the A option for this. And after that, now we go for the another question. Which one of the following is correctly matched pair of the given secretion and its primary role in human physiology? Once again, which one of the following is correctly matched pair of the given secretion and its primary role in human physiology? The options are given like that. A, sebum. Sebum is nothing but a kind of oily substance which is always helpful to protect the internal parts while it is forming the sebum layer. Sebum is not at all helpful in the sexual attraction in between male and female of mammals itself. The B option is the sweat glands. Naturally, the sweat glands are the true glands and which are always maintaining the ideal temperature or normal temperature of the body. For example, during the summer, the intensity of the environmental temperature is more, due to intake of more water, and the sweat glands that sweat the water to compensate and to minimize the increased body temperature. That's why the sweat glands are always maintaining the thermoregulation. What do you mean of thermoregulation? Maintenance of the constant body temperature irrespective of the seasons of a year. So that's why the B option is correct option for this. And the C option, saliva. Saliva is naturally secreted by the salivary glands which are helpful to partially digesting the carbohydrates. And C also not correct for this, and D option is the tears. Excretion of the salts. It is there when the people are very happy and when the people are so sad, certainly the lacrimal glands are present in the eyes which are able to secrete the tears. But the tears are not a source of eliminate the salts itself. That's why between the A, B, C, D, only the B option is correct for this. So I am opting the B option for this itself. And after that, the last question is the 28th question. A condition in which body's internal environment remains nearly constant is called. A condition in which body's internal environment remains nearly constant is called. Hematoma. It is not related to this. Hematoma is always just concentrated on the constant number of the blood cells. And the hemostasis. That means the blood of the human body naturally contains different concentrated chemical system. The maintenance of the concentration of different chemicals of the blood is called hemostasis. And after that, hemopoiesis. The production of the blood cells from the bone marrow can be named as the hemopoiesis. Of course, hemopoiesis is naturally classified into two types also. Erythropoiesis, that is the name of the process which is involved in the production of RBC, and leukopoiesis. Leukopoiesis is the second process which is involved in the production of the WBC cell. So that's why hemopoiesis is not at all concerned with the maintenance of the internal environmental conditions of the human body. So when you define the hematoma, hemostasis and hemopoiesis, the three of the processes are not at all concerned with this question. The left one is the D option. So naturally we are opting the D option for the correct option for this. So homeostasis is the name of the process which is involving in the maintenance of the internal environments constantly itself. What is the name of the process? Homeostasis itself. So I too opting the D option for this question. In that way, I am concluding today's class. Thank you for all, and we'll meet our next class with another topic itself.